Hi, I'm Andy McDonald. I'm with the Fort Vancouver Composite Squadron here in the Washington Wing Civil Air Patrol. As you go through your training to earn your airborne photographer certification, one of the most important skills that you're going to develop is the ability to pre-flight and set up the camera. And in this case, it's going to be the Nikon D7200. When you first open the case and you look at all the features on the camera, it could be a little bit overwhelming. But I'm going to show you today that as long as you just follow the checklist and do a few key steps, you're only a few minutes away from having the camera configured, ready to take awesome pictures even on your first flight. So if you're ready, let's dive in and get started.
We'll be right back.
And there you have it. Your camera is fully pre-flighted now and ready to go. Here's a few more tips for you as you head out to go fly. We often don't take the hard case with us due to weight and space issues. So remember, when you're carrying the camera to and from the plane, always do it with the strap around your neck, and that'll avoid you accidentally dropping it and doing damage. Tips for in the airplane: when you're stowing the camera in the back seat, put it in a safe place so it won't fall. Always keep the lens cap on when you're in between photo sessions. And remember, often the GPS unit can lose its lock when it's inside the aircraft. And so before you get to the next target, you might need to hold the camera up to either the front or the back window, depending on where you're sitting, and make sure you have a good GPS signal before you start taking pictures. Other than that, I think you're good to go. Have a great mission, and we'll see you at the next training. Thank you very much.